We're fading a money, right here.
Late, the controversial MP arrived, her political foe waiting.
In Ipswich, in Queensland, in 1996, an old Labor town took a hard turn to the right. An unknown woman swept into National Parliament. A fish and chip shop owner catapulted to fame with the biggest electoral swing in the nation.
I believe we are in danger of being swamped by Asians.
Today, an outpouring of anti-racism sentiments at rallies.
Immigration must be halted in the short term. This nation is being divided into black and white. One people, one nation, one flag.
Colene Hanson's One Nation.
Within months, her new party was threatening the political status quo.
Joined the branch with the idea I was going to be a candidate. I joined with the idea I might be able to do something. And the first night I was there, they decided they needed someone who could be secretary, and who I consider it. The next thing I know, I'm being promoted inside the committee meetings to consider being a candidate.
In 1998, another Ipswich woman, Colene Hughes, was about to enter the world of politics.
342,587k on the clock. She's not a bad old beast. My fix it still works.
She was one of thousands responding to Pauline Hanson's call to save the nation.
This is a part of Australia that I feel very much at home in, because I was brought up in this sort of environment. Ipswich has been largely ignored for the last 25 or 30 years because it's been considered to be a safe seat for the Labor Party. So the Labor Party haven't bothered to do anything with it or for it because they figure they don't have to, they'll all vote for them anyway. And when there's been a Liberal Party in government, they haven't bothered too much either.
The Labor Party isn't the Labor Party that I believe in and I grew up with. Because, using the old cliches, the Labor Party used to be for the working man because every one of them was a working man, not an educated twerp.
Pauline, Ipswich workers' hero. Pauline, Oxley's number one.
We sent it down to Canberra to help sort the country's ills.
Ipswich was once the heartland of industrial Queensland. Over the past 20 years, its mines have closed. The woolen mills have shut down, the railway workshops have been moved out, and unemployment has risen to over 10%.
Pauline, Oxley's number one.
The World Bank really has done this to this country here. You cannot control a country that doesn't owe you money. How do you control a person? If they're in debt to you, they'll do just about anything. Australia was a creditor nation. People owed us money. We are now a debtor nation. And we are in so much debt for every man, woman and child, we will never get out of it unless we do something to restructure the way our country works. And the way to control Australia and make it do what you want it to do is have it in debt. And Whitlam and Fraser and Hawke, they allowed this to happen with their policies, and they're all working towards the same end, and they're all Fabian socialists.
Maybe the major parties shouldn't have campaigned at all, because One Nation support has grown as the political leaders have crisscrossed the state.
When the Queensland state elections were called for June 1998, the new party had a chance to test its strength.
Front page news. Trucks come past, dur, 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 dur. Cars go past, yay, One Nation! You think, what on earth's going on here? I've never seen anything like this in politics before.
Because you don't normally hear, yay, Liberal Party, or yay, Labor Party, it's, you know.
Colene is running for One Nation in the safe Labor seat of Bundamba.
Yes, today is the launch of the campaign, but the full foot slogging will start on Monday. Mm-hmm. Colene's going to be going through the shopping centres, all that sort of thing, and meeting the people. And
what this government should be doing is picking on a small boat, about 20 or 30 people, have a video going, blast them out of the water and send a video across the world. I hear that from every household.
People are suggesting this.
You've only got to blow one lot up and the rest won't come. If they were true refugees, if their life was in danger, Why don't they just go across the Mediterranean into Europe? Why are they getting on a boat and coming all the way out here?
There are new suburbs that are typically oriental suburbs with these fancy little duvets on the roof and whatnot, and you drive through it and you could be back in old Shanghai. At the moment they're new and clean, but you can see what they're going to become. All these little houses will have clothes always hanging on the line. I don't know if it's they just go and take something off when they want to wear it or what, but to us as English, that's an untidy. We don't want Australia looking like that. We like our backyards with trees in them. If you've got people who can't communicate on a speaking level or on a spiritual level,
that's it. Divide and conquer.
Divide and conquer.
And just maybe if we all gather together and we fight against what is going on, against being governed by bureaucracy, taking back control of our government, then maybe we can take back our own country.
Queensland's election today to test whether the One Nation Party is a real force.
Colene has a fight on her hands. Her opponent, Bob Gibbs, has been a Labor MP for 22 years.
And you're my dad.
I'm Colene's father.
Oh, okay. Nice to meet you.
I've been playing politics for the last 35 years. Whether it's Labor or Liberal, neither have been listening. And One Nation's a chance to make them listen. Even if One Nation never governs, at least it makes them listen and take notice. We're all hurting out here.
People coming and saying, you know, One Nation, good. Oh. You know, we've had people go past in the cars and shouting out the window. They are sick there again, One Nation.
Probably 18 months ago we were a movement, 12 months ago we were a party. We've just fielded 79, 78 candidates against 89 seats. And I've never run in a state election before. I've never run in local council elections. I've never done this before.
Our preference forms were nowhere to be found. People have taken them. And I said, what are you keeping those for? And they said, this is political history for Australia.
I hit the ground running, and I've done this in less than 3 weeks. That I give him a nudge at all, I'll be pleased.
Personally, it's an experience. Wouldn't be dead for quids, wouldn't we? Because this could be history.
Early counting signals an unprecedented turn in Australian political history.
Our first figures have come in from one polling booth at Gales. One Nation, 135 votes, ALP, 269 votes, Liberal, 24 votes, Green, 15 votes, Democrat, 18. I'm not too sure. I think that's an 18% swing to One Nation from Liberal to One Nation.
We won Bundamba TAFE on primaries. We beat Bob Gibbs by 23 votes. That's for Colene, yes. Isn't that great?
If I win this, I will be in there fighting for the people of Bundamba, because that'll be the job I have, won't it? Just that simple. To me, life's pretty simple.
Now, you must be stunned by the result in Ipswich.
That's exactly right. I've lost a good 28% of the primary vote, and David Hamill's lost about 10% of the primary vote. They've ripped the coalition apart in Ipswich, but then again, it is One Nation heartland, isn't it?
It is the site of the most famous fish and chip shop in Australia.
In its first electoral test, One Nation captures nearly a quarter of the vote, winning 11 seats.
Even though we've had the greatest slandering media misrepresentation of our policies, the public have seen through it. And it just, you know, people power has really taken over here. Yeah.
The Labor Party only just staggers into office, but the eyes of the country are on Colene.
Thank you.
Although she fails to win her seat, Colene gains a third of the primary vote and is ready for her next step.
They only have just over 10% of the MPs, but One Nation continued to dominate the political scene in Queensland today as Parliament sat for the first time since the election. The party's 11 new members, watched by Pauline Hanson, took their seat...
And I said to him that calling her deranged, simplistic and racist hasn't worked, so what does he plan to do now to stop her?
I hope that One Nation just dissolves.
Three months later, the federal election campaign begins. Hoping to stop Hanson, the major parties direct their preferences away from One Nation. Pauline Hanson is now running for the seat of Blair, and Colene is running for Hanson's old seat of Oxley.
On the track, Jack.
From the outset, One Nation is under fire and on the defensive.
They're yelling and screaming and calling us fascists and Nazis and all this sort of weird talk that is really unwarranted, because there's nothing fascist about the organisation, there's nothing neo-Nazi about the organisation. I personally think Australia is a wonderful place. We are this potpourri of people from all over the world. And I'm out of Oxley into Blair or Ford at the moment, trying to find this guy that I can deliver this kit to who's going to run this booth. Isn't that wonderful?
We've still got another 29 kits to deliver, don't we?
Yeah.
Go out into the highway, then keep on going.
This movement is to get back power to the people. Our politicians don't listen to us.
Okay, guys, thanks.
And this is why One Nation's come up from the ground like it has. Not because everybody thinks Pauline Hanson is fabulous and the sun shines out of her ears. It's just that she's there, and it gave everyone a focus and it galvanised people together.
Actually, I don't think she knows how to take me either. I think she's gotten quite used to a whole lot of people being very a la Samish, and she's not quite... It's a little different for her to have someone come on the scene like me that walks in, puts out my hand and says, "G'day, how are you?" And I mean exactly that. G'day and how are you?
There was one back there as well. It was an actual driveway.
Oh, if this isn't it, they won't shoot us.
Hopefully.
Face I recognise. How are you?
Good. Excuse, but how many out of those cards you got?
About 500, sorry.
That should be okay.
Oh, just see, 400 or so.
There's a bikey rally, there's a cycling thing in Cowbar, there's fishing competitions on. You know, it cut me. I'm going to have enough workers. But it was pretty hard rounding them up. You know, some of us will have to do 8 and 9 hour stretches. But... Righto, thanks for that.
360, come on, Wolf.
Life's not bad, you know. So you got to spend your days washing carrots. I reckon it'd be worth it to be able to live like this.
Back in Harrisville, and we do some of this letterbox dropping I intended to do.
Across the state, in the back blocks and bush halls, support is growing for Pauline Hanson and her party. But media attacks on One Nation have fueled suspicion and anger.
You don't belong to some feminist organisation, no?
No, we're independent.
The Stolen Generation, yes, they were. But what would you like to do as a police officer? And you were working out in the western parts of Queensland, and you see a drunken mother dying, and she would probably be dead next day, and you see a poor little little skinny children, little black kids, skinny, poor, little starving children, probably die in a couple of days. Now, what will you do? I ask you, what would you do? And today, they are 40, 50 years of age, and now they are asking us to apologise to them because they were stolen from their bloody family, for Christ's sake. You apologise to me. We want the apologies. Not us apologise to you, because we did a damn good job in looking after your skin, your hide.
Get in the real world, for God's sake. Have a look at those pet there. That's Australia there. Call a girl, slip all alone. And when they gather near, all the things you see, girls from the east and from the west, no matter how they try to tease me, it's you I always love the best. The girls in Sydney may be sassy, however far I roam, when I blink my eyes, I realize it's you I want all alone. The girls in Sydney may be sassy, however far I go. When I flinch my eyes, then I realize all I want is you all alone.
How far away from an Aboriginal have you got to be before you're still called an Aboriginal? If you're breeding cattle or horses, the first cross is 50% either way. And then if you go back to a purebred like a white person, it comes to 3/4. 4 is 4/4, but genuinely 5 is purebred. They're still calling themselves Aboriginals. Black fellas never do much. They love sitting down under trees. They'll sit there all day and night. No, they're not good runners. Cathy Freeman should never carry the Aboriginal flag. She should carry the ordinary Australian flag, because if it wasn't, the Aboriginal didn't make her run, it was the white blood that sent her that made her run. And I'm not going to condemn her in any way, because she's a pretty good runner. No, I'm not racist, not in any way. But I did get trained in 14 years old to shoot the Jap. I'd have to say I'm racist against the Japs, yeah. And so was hundreds of others. If you knew what they did, you and me too. And I still hate them. And you can put that on television if you say desire. They never want to trust the Japanese.
Back on the campaign trail, all is not well. Colleen's outspoken views and questioning of party directives have landed her in trouble.
Colleen was invited along to the Archerfield branch meeting. She was told it was an AGM, that she had no right to be there, and she was physically removed, the whole box and dice. So we lost 30 booth workers down there.
Money is proving to be an added pressure.
Well, I just wanted to come by here to see if there was any dramas, and Father's having a fit because Vic's fallen over on the job, OK?
If you've got 10 minutes, 15 minutes, do you want a cup of coffee?
Because if you wait 2 minutes, I'll come directly back. If you're not going to wait, I've got something else I'll come back, thanks.
Well, Colleen's still waiting for her money back from the state campaign.
I'm on tablets to keep myself calm, and they're not working. I've got to see my shrink on Wednesday and tell him you better triple it because it's not working at the moment.
If some of us candidates are coming out and saying things that we believe in that might not be particularly the party line, or might not be what everyone's convinced would be what Pauline would say, then it is not their place to sanction us because of that.
The One Nation Party is in splinters tonight.
I am the president of One Nation and I'm going to control it.
The defectors say they can no longer work within a dictatorial party structure headed by Pauline Hanson, David Oldfield and David Ettridge.
For the party, the honeymoon is over. Members are defecting. They say they've been bullied for speaking out. One Nation says it's a media beat-up.
I'm a mother. Australia is my home. And the Australian people are my children.
At that branch meeting when they were saying, oh, the QECC are lovely people, they've done wonderful things for you, I did this. That's been done on purpose. They've mucked around with my hairdo, they've put shadows in that I think probably wouldn't even be there, I'm not sure. It takes a fair bit to move me to tears, but when they turned up here, all 100 of them, I was.
Five days before the election, One Nation launches their campaign. David Oldfield, national advisor to the party, has come up from Sydney. He's resented by some Queensland members as the power behind the throne.
Abuse, race-based policy and the destruction of our national pride and heritage through inappropriate immigration and the segregation that is multiculturalism. Our own flag, our own people, our own language, our own future. Our own nation.
James is waiting for you outside with the various policy documentation from today and a copy of the speech. Thank you for your attendance.
We got promises for the last 2 weeks.
Outside, journalists quiz Oldfield about One Nation's policies.
We have asked David Oldfield, we have asked One Nation, how are you going to pay for these? And they have told us today we will get detailed costings. Australians have a right to see them before they go to the polls.
Ladies and gentlemen, I would ask you not to become involved in arguments with the media. They are not worth it. Thank you very much.
Oldfield responds by calling in the police to remove the journalists.
While the media are able to contain themselves, we will be able to contain ourselves. So
to be able to see just exactly what the media, in particular elements of the Sydney media, are like, and Canberra press go.
Yeah, yeah. Mr. Oldfield, can't just explain why the documents
are
not here?
Just give us an explanation.
How are the police going?
The media is now banned from covering One Nation's campaign.
Why aren't they here, Mr. Oldfield?
Election night, and early counting again signals a swing towards One Nation. The fear, the hope is, if One Nation polls well, it could hold the balance of power in Australia.
You go into one booth and everybody says, oh, there she is, and you go into another booth and they go, ah, oh, scumbag, One Nation.
One Nation's primary vote is strong, but without the preference votes of the other parties, they can't win.
Bundamba School, Mr. Ripple, got 839. I got 447.
I reckon it's 838.
Right. I got 447 and Marie Forbes got 362. So I'm ahead of the Liberal Party and behind the Labor.
Down but not finished.
No, mate, we did well.
Yeah.
A first just run at a federal seat, I'm not upset.
We've learned a lot and you've done exceedingly well.
Thanks,
you're
so
great, kid.
If she doesn't win her seat, One Nation will survive. You can't stop this thing. It's been bigger than Pauline Hanson for 3 or 4 months. Once we get over this, we get the branches running and the branches become a conduit for the information from the public up to the candidate into the parliament. We don't live in some sort of a maniacal monarchy. We do live in a democracy. And I'm a bigger screaming Democrat than any Democrat you'd find out there.
Colleen fails to win Oxley. Pauline Hanson fails in Blair. And One Nation fails to win a single seat. When their fate becomes evident, the media is banished from the party's tally room.
Please leave now.
Stay. I mean it. Stay.
Look, he's better go.
No, they're mine.
They've been asked to go.
Colin. They're a documentary team. The media has been asked to leave.
I know exactly
you
who they are.
Move away, please. Go. I mean it. Go. Goodbye.
I can stay here.
Fine, stay here. Don't order my people around. Back off. I'm going to end up smacking him right in the bloody nuts one day. Him.
Do you want me to tell you what I think went wrong? Having Pauline say, I feel like the mother of the nation. I mean, that is so absurd. That is so arrogant. You know, here you have this ignorant, arrogant woman running around saying, I feel like the mother of the nation. Everybody's going, oh, my God. Oh, please. Somebody put a sock in it. You know, how can we deal with this? And you're out there trying to defend that, you know. And then you go to the Gatton campaign launch and here's Oldfield openly fighting with the media, stirring them up, egging them on, getting them all excited and then throwing them out. Of course they give you a bad report.
Now I must point out to you that those knockers, I don't think I have to name them for you, but they're the same people who thought we could have done better, are the same people who've never done anything. Nothing at all. Barely achieved to stay alive themselves, let alone actually have any sort of conquering force as far as a political party is concerned.
He leant across into the middle of the table, put his hand in the middle of the table and said, ha! You got any idea how hopeless most of these candidates really are? And I realised out of the corner of my eye, Jack Paff sitting beside me was raising his right arm off the table and it was forming into a fist and it was just about right in line with young son's chin.
People throw up to me all the time, but we want democracy. Democracy really means mob rule. What can't you do now that if you would change anything, what you could do?
I said, democratic principles is what will make this thing work. I said, you go out there and you say to people, this is what our men fought for and died for. Yes, they did. I said, they fought for us to be able to live under democratic principles. Democracy is not mob rule.
And there's too many people out there who think they can make the decisions, but I tell you, they can't. And a lot of these people have already come from failed organisations. They want to be as if they could be, but they can't be.
Honey, you got something that worries you? He's pretty clever, isn't he? There he is, he's dead now. It worries you and it's smaller than you and it's going to bite you and hurt you, you can kill it.
In the aftermath of the election, One Nation enters a new era. Hanson, Oldfield and the party's national director, David Ettridge, draw up a constitution. Executive power will rest solely in their hands.
What's going on at the moment is they're trying to push through a constitution
without giving us as members much time to nut out, to go through.
It leaves the whole organisation open to financial abuse. It gives the national executive the ability to not just borrow money, but to lend money almost indiscriminately.
It's a fait accompli that they're going to be running the show even after the AGM, because the constitution states that Etheridge will be there for 2 years minimum, Oldfield 3 years, Pauline 4 years, and then they can decide after that if they want to go any further.
Threatened with a full-scale revolt, Hanson, Oldfield and Etheridge withdraw the constitution. The national executive will now be elected at the annual general meeting in Sydney. Colene arrives armed with the proxy votes of absent branch members and prepared for a fight.
We've been locked in the car for 10 hours, we're told.
She is already marked as a troublemaker.
When I see something wrong, I yell about it. I point the finger and whistle. Mr. Etheridge has tried to sack me on a trumped-up charge, and the branch executive said, you take her, you take us. So he backed off.
We've not been able to really canvass for anyone. It's been dictated by Sydney that you don't contact each other, that you don't talk, that you don't liaise, that you don't try and work together. So it's made it virtually impossible to put anybody up. In a truly democratic party where the involvement of all members is encouraged and where no one is afraid to speak their mind, nobody needs to stack a meeting with proxies to get their way. Instead, we accept that everyone has a contribution to make and sometimes their views are different to ours.
We have secret ballots.
Secret ballots and secret ballots.
When we don't know who the numbers are or where they've come from, how could we possibly be prepared to accept any number of proxies that they hold?
They can vote themselves into for all sorts of power, money, anything they like on so-called proxy votes. At any given time, he's got the power to pull whoever he likes out of the system and just say, goes to the data database and says, gone, deleted, push of a button, you're deleted, you're out. So I wouldn't be a bit surprised to roll up there tomorrow to find my name.
We're all struck
deleted.
Off.
You're deleted.
We would have fallen in a great big heap a long time ago without the discipline of everybody marching in step to the same tune. So don't confuse strong leadership and strong management with anything except strong leadership and strong management. Protecting is to stop our opponents from destroying us and to stop those people within us who think for $20 or $40 they can become a member and then start working inside the camp to destroy us. Don't let that happen. Look for them in your branches and put a stop to them.
And 6 years ago, the Bulletin magazine in the 93 election put out an article on their front pages. They were decrying the lack of vision, the lack of leadership. And they said, where is this saviour figure coming? Well, it took another federal election to come. And there's that saviour figure sitting right there. And we're all here because of that saviour figure. Such a good job of making sure that saviour figure brought this One Nation party into being, and I know it's wonderful to stand before you as a family. Because 1 million voters voted for us, and they know that they've been sold down the track, they know that Australia's been betrayed. And every day when we've got our school children raising the flag, singing the anthem, I want them to remember this, because never, never again shall these traitors ever get away with what they've done. Member again.
David's talking.
Just respect also the media.
Before the leadership ballot, Hanson addresses the waiting media.
Meeting going on
from members from all over Australia.
Actually show the media the spirit of what is taking place in our meeting, as opposed to the distortions. So could I please ask you, who is here today to support Pauline Hanson and One Nation? Do we have one or two dissidents?
Yeah.
Do we have thousands, thousands of members who are happy?
You have come here today, the media, and I don't know if you're reasons. I don't know the reasons for actually coming here today, but it was not to pick up any dissent within One Nation. We are strong, we are united, and we have got a long way to go. And this is the support that we have. People from all different walks of life, all different nationalities have come together because we are Australians.
Yes!
So the support is there. There may be a few people who've got nothing better to do than come out here and express a few concerns. But the support is with One Nation, and the members here are very proud to be here to stand united beside each other. And we have been represented for Australia-wide. I'm proud of each and every one of you. We will have our vote this afternoon for who will be on the National Executive. And if you choose me to be your leader, I will go on to be your leader with pride and dignity. And
three cheers for Paul!
Is for National President. Is there anyone who wishes to vote? And please feel free, we do have a democracy here. The wheels of democracy grind slowly, but they are grinding. Is there anyone who wishes to vote against Pauline for President? Does anyone wish to do that? No, right. Can we record? Can we please have a show of hands that the minutes will record? Pauline Hanson was voted.
Number two of the National Executive. There are a number of people who are nominated and have been seconded. Are there any further nominations?
Can nominations be closed?
Seconded for that? Okay, slight nominations are now closed. I will declare David Oldfield elected unopposed.
They opened the nominations, they closed the nominations, they elected him unopposed, they did not. A vote.
It's a bit like Hitler, I suppose, in the sense that people just don't pay any attention to what the person's saying, or maybe they do, but they just believe totally. And I think, as Pauline has always said, consultation, discussion, to democracy, that's what we stand for as a party.
Colene Hughes. This vote is for Colene Hughes from the Ipswich branch.
Colene is nominated for a position on the National Executive. She never had a chance.
Guys, here comes the little whoopee.
There's probably not many of them there.
If I'm from the bad part of Queensland, I'll just hotwire it.
So what do you think? What about today? Mate, can you add up? One stage there, we got a vote count. 6,584 for a motion.
30 against and 11 abstentions.
3,790
were held by
Pauline,
David Ettridge, David Oldfield,
Pauline
Hanson. It's more than half the 662733.
So in other words, nothing could be beaten.
Every time they wanted something, they got it.
So in other words, if we had a move of any motions or of any descriptions, we're outvoted before we started.
I was asked by 19 people to be their voice down here today.
We were told to vote for Pauline Hanson by all our branches.
For the two Davids.
But not for the two Davids. We did not vote for the two Davids.
So there I voted against them because I was under instruction.
No, we didn't. We couldn't vote against the Davids.
No, we couldn't. They never.
Because
I intended to vote against them. They didn't have a vote. Yeah. There wasn't a vote. We couldn't vote against them.
Mm. Yeah.
Hello.
Hi, can I see?
Yes?
I was just sort of joining in.
Oh.
Oh, well, we're just a bit curious as to who you are.
Well, it's all right. I know who you are.
Do you?
Yes, you've been up the stage. I know who you are.
That's the sort of standard tactics.
That's what you get. That's typical of the carry-on. She comes and stands here and butts in on that and then won't tell me who she is. Doesn't have the decency to tell me who she is.
And then drives away and says you'll find out.
Pauline Hanson ran this meeting, and David Ettridge and David Oldfield ran this meeting purely for a democratic view, and everybody was allowed to have their say. If you felt that you didn't have your say, well, that's your problem. It's just sour grapes on your behalf because you weren't elected, and I'm sorry, that's all it is. Sour grapes.
It is not sour grapes because I didn't get onto the national
what were the
executive.
Numbers,
it is not. It is
what
not.
What were the numbers that you felt were somehow affected?
Well, we were just going through the numbers here. 6,584 was for a motion. 30 against and 11 were abstentions.
Yep.
That makes a total of 6,627.
Yep.
Right? Now, you held 109. David Oldfield had 309. Sorry, David Ettridge 109. David Oldfield 395.
Yep.
And 3,300 and something Pauline held. That is more than half. The three of those together are more than half.
That's quite irrelevant.
So it's just
right.
that
right.
simple.
Let me show what a troublemaker you are, Colleen, because that's all you are. Take out all of Pauline's, take out all of David's, take out all of David's, the second one, and you'll find that you now have something in the order of over 2,000 people defeating 30. You are nothing but a troublemaker and you can't even add up.
Thank you, David.
You know,
I'd like to see the numbers because
well,
these numbers indicate that it was the other
if
way.
If you had a problem, why didn't you come
excuse
and
Excuse me, look, you're not playing
problem,
with a full deck, eh? You're not playing with a full deck, Colin. You're not going to fool around with this sort of bullshit anymore. It's quite clear in there that there are more than 2,000 people that were represented by people other than Pauline Hanson who conclusively defeated something like 30. Democracy has been demonstrated to you in such overwhelming numbers that we would have to clearly question your sanity, to be quite frank.
Now,
I don't even care if that offends you. I really don't, Colin.
I know you don't.
Because you are one of the troublemakers, and you are one of about five or six, and that is it. You bring up points which are completely irrelevant. Every vote here was clearly undertaken with considerable democracy, complete democracy, totally. And
I
here you have, without even
it.
Pauline's proxies, thousands of people.
I personally find it, if you would like, now you've had your say, I will say this, I find it immoral and unconscionable that people standing on a national executive of an organisation would be holding all those proxies. I don't think that's
really well. Who else is allowed to hold?
I think the branches should have brought the proxies of their membership. I really do.
The branches could have done that if they'd liked, if the members had decided to do that. So you want to dictate to the members to create a situation that suits you.
There were many of our members who never received a proxy in the mail.
Well, then they mustn't be members. Every member in this country
received a proxy. Oh yes, they are.
Our
membership secretary checked it out extensively. He checked with Claire. Doug Abbott checked with Claire on who was on the membership list.
I wouldn't even believe hardly anything you've got to say about any issue.
Well, then check with Doug Abbott.
I actually worked in the office and the proxy form was mailed on my own.
Well, then
my husband didn't get one.
Julie didn't get one.
Colleen's a liar.
Sorry, guys, I'm upset. I believe this to be the last chance we have. I really did. And it doesn't have a hope. I joined it because I believed it to be the last bastion of democratically principled political party in this country. I don't like being not so much conned, but
sort of gathered along. It's not really, I suppose maybe it is a con. I put a lot of time, effort, energy and money into this thing, believing it to be something other than what it was. And I conned myself because I wanted so much to believe that it was what I wanted it to be.
Where is the difference between down there at Rudy Hill, Pauline, and see Kyle? It was that bit that frightened me.
That was very scary.
It was very scary. That was not a political party. That was blind following.
You can't put her in the same category as the inimitable Mr. Oldfield. Mr. Oldfield has always run his own agenda, right? Pauline has no conception. She doesn't know world history. She doesn't know political history. She doesn't know current political rules. You could sit her down, if you could get her to sit down and read Mein Kampf, it probably still wouldn't dawn on her. I don't know what you could do. Maybe you could do it in picture form. Maybe you could show her a picture of Hitler sitting on the corner of the desk with the swastika draped around his shoulders and a picture of her with the Australian flag draped around her. Maybe you could show her pictures of Oldfield saying, I'm a national socialist, and we all know what that means, and pictures of Oldfield, I put them both together so much, Hitler and him beating up the crowds, right, and the Nazi party and what it did. You might eventually, if you sit with flashcards and show her, because it's not something that's ever been in history. The woman is ignorant only because she doesn't know.
Police raids at the party's Ipswich and Sydney headquarters after fraud allegations had the party...
A year later, the law had caught up with One Nation. The party, it turned out, was a commercial enterprise, incorporated by Hanson and the two Davids. The party members were not members at all, but fundraisers for a party of three.
As long as they don't bankrupt me, and then I intend to stand for Parliament.
As Ettridge explained, the party had a special structure, a defensive structure to protect it from dangerous elements. One by one, the people discovered he was talking about them.
You give me one reason. Why should I vote for someone who is rude and arrogant? I like you. I'm not a lesbian. I don't like you because of your looks, because you are just ordinary person like me. I like you because I'm hurt. I'm hurt and hurt and hurt. And people, what's happening here, everybody voted for you, not because you are intelligent or because you are good looking, because you are one of us. People cried when you lost because we lost our hope. We lost our future. I come from Yugoslavia. Yugoslavia, they lost their lives. Australia will be next. The people have no work. There is no jobs. You go out there and see jobs are only casual. The small business is gone. Small business is gone. The jobs is gone. Now we've lost our social security. The people here who are jumping the queue from different countries, I don't care about religion, but they come in here, Pauline, they come in here, they're taking my money, which I worked all 30 years for this country. How do you think I feel?
Ladies and gentlemen, first and foremost, a party needs members. Go out and recruit.
It's like supporting a footy team. You go through season after season, they get beaten, they get whooped and everything like that, and you don't know when they're going to win their next game or get to the next grand final or whatever. But when it comes down, someone says, who do you support? You always support your own team. And what I'm supporting with, under the label of One Nation, is people that I have a lot of respect for, like the Doug Abbotts of this world. And whether it turns out to be an absolute stuff-up in the end and wrong, well, so be it. But history doesn't record all the little people that stood by certain things. They only record the people that make the big bangs in life, and I'm one of the little people.
Financially, I got a house that's not finished. Emotionally, it's cost me 2 years of my life. And it's taken a toll on me personally, in my personal life, and I didn't just have a go. I put everything in there. And when I stood for the election campaigns, I drew on every marker, on every favour, on every penny. And I wasn't the only one. This is the thing. I'm not a Mohican. There are many other people out there who did exactly the same thing. Good night then, everybody. I'm headed home.
Angie, don't forget to write me a letter.
In the end, Colene left One Nation to stand as an independent. Pauline Hanson's One Nation Party continues to run in state and federal elections.